as usual. There's a few some massages. We're going to get down to the floor very shortly, but just walk it up. Yeah, always walk it up. And just a four. And three, get the feet nice and activated, and everything else follows. Now, stepping to one end of the mat, inhale, lift up, and then really take a big stretch here. Reach up, reach down with your feet, reach up with your hands. And then scoop the navel to the spine, roll your way down, minding your furniture. And at the bottom here, inhale, bending the knees. Exhale, slowly stretch the legs. Inhale, bending the knees. Exhale, slowly straighten the legs. One more inhale. Those of you who are working with slightly tighter hamstrings, just straighten to where you feel your hamstrings. Not a problem there. Now everyone, bending the knees, is placing the hands firmly on the mat, step back to the high plank. And then gently rock forward and back, and forward and back. And soften the elbows and separate the shoulder blades away from each other, pushing away from the floor. And just a four and back, and three and back, last two and back. Last one. Now step the feet as wide as your mat, just adjusting the music level. Stepping the feet as wide as your mat, and then finding a nice wide base. You're down on one elbow, the other. And hands and elbows. Elbows, those of you who need a bit of a support, put the knees down, but do try to stay in a plank position. So with the knees down, you're in three quarter. With the knees up, you're in a full plank. Down and back up and up. Let's have two more. Come on. And down and back up and up. Last one, down and down. Find yourself in elbow plank. Step the feet back in together. And now take a moment. If you're struggling already, bring the knees down and rest on your three-quarter plank. Just keeping yourself nice and calm is just a fitness class. And from here, let's all dip the knee on the floor and slowly straighten the leg back up. So knees tap and straighten. And tap and straighten. So tap and straighten. And let's speed it up if you are feeling very happy with your form. So tap. Now these faster options are for people who really, really know about their form. So if you're in any way slightly wobbly, just stay on nice and slow. Focusing on your form. Shoulder blades away from each other and squeeze those glutes. Lift the belly button. Shoulders over those elbows. Now just 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, and two, find the plank or gently lower yourself all the way down onto your front and roll over onto your back. Here we go. And now we haven't done this for a while, so let's get on. Lengthen the legs, give the legs a quick wiggle to make sure there's no tension held in the hip flexors. Now, wrapping a little grip and slide it between your lower back and the floor so that maintaining a neutral spine, hands going behind your hips. From here, ladies. Keeping the back nice and neutral, minding the little grade between the lower back and the floor, we're crunching up, not squashing the grade. So it's up and up. Now forcing your body to stay nice and long, forcing your back to stay nice and neutral. That little grade is still very much happy and intact between the back and the floor. It's up. Now this long position, allow the pelvic floor to really lift and you're working into your entire front. So naturally, with that neutral spine, you can't curl up too high, but it's not about the height. Focus on that neutral spine. Go lift, up, up. Go squeeze, and up, and up. Here's 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. One more 8. Here we go. Here's 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Now head and shoulders stay up, placing one foot on the floor and placing the other foot on the floor. Press the whole spine down. Now you squash the little grip. Wiggle the feet slightly further away from you. Now from here, ladies, keep the head and shoulders. Can you curl up any higher? Now picking up one foot, 1 centimeter, half an inch off the floor, and put it back down. And the other foot, 1 centimeter off the floor and down. You see in the video, you can barely see me move. And the other side, when you're ready, both feet up 1 centimeter and down and down. Both feet up and hold and down, floating up half an inch and down. The whole feet come off the floor, so try not to leave the heels or leave the toes on the floor. Last two up and down. Last one, keep those feet just hovering off the floor. Now crunching up, up, go squeeze. The feet are hovering tantalizingly just off the floor. lift that pelvic floor, go squeeze. Those of you who are struggling, just tap the toe gently on the floor, yeah? Keep the legs as light as you can. Crunching up. Yes, 8, 7, 6, 5, and 4, 3. Now keep the head and shoulders off the floor, both knees up off your hips, and back to that hover. Woo! Exhale up over the hips. Those of you modifying, you can just do one leg at a time and come in, making sure you're moving from the hips and not from the knees. All up and up. Those of you who want to take a little, a bit happier middle ground, you can move both legs and put them both back on the floor. The advance, guys, just keep the feet hovering off the floor and come back to the tabletop. Lower down to hovering off the floor. All these options for you to try. Guys, 4 more here. Up and lower. Lower. 3 more. Up. Up and lower. Last 2. Exhale. Shh. Inhale. Hold spine pressing down to the floor, guys. Your back is safe. Last 1. You hover. Come back to the tabletop. Straighten the legs out to 90, head and shoulders down. Lower abs, flex the feet from here, guys. Inhale, exhale, curl the bum off the floor. Inhale, put it down. Exhale, curl the bum off the floor. Inhale, put it down. So up and low, and curl and low. Curl it up and lower and up. Now use your arms to press down as much as you need to if you need the support. And up and lower. Now for those of you working with an interesting, you know, challenging back like myself, some days I really can't do it without my arms, yeah? So do whatever you can, guys. Little curl up and lower. Up and lower. And up, lower. Exhale. Last one. Keep the bum off the floor. Now pose up. 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 And squeeze. Breathe into that pelvic floor. Go press up. If you're available, if the hamstrings allow you, straighten the legs all the way. Up. Attaining a gorgeous L shape. And for those of you who want to, head and shoulders come up, and then everything reach up, everything crunch and up. Now, other options, if you had enough, just keep the head and shoulders down and curl into that lower abs. Coming for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Nice, hands go back behind your head and put the bum back on the floor. From here, swipe the legs down to 90, 45 degrees. And back up to 90. And down to 45 and back up to 90. Let's go. Hips down for 2 and back up for 2. And down for 2 and back up. Last 2. Take it down and back up. Last 1. Down. Now coming back to 90. And now go crunching up. Of course, this is not all we're going to do. From here, keep the legs going. Keep that smile on your face as you slow the legs down for 2 and back up for 2. Legs down as you crunch and up as you crunch. And crunch, crunch down and crunch, crunch up. 4 more down and up and up. 3 more down and back up and up. Last 2 and down and back up. Last 1, guys. Keep the legs low. Final 16 crunches. Go. Lift up. And up. If you're struggling, legs go higher. If you're struggling, arms out on either side. Let's go. 8 more. Yes, 8, 7. Options, guys. Yeah, if you're really, really head enough, put the feet down. Last 4, 3, 2, and 1. Nice one. Have a big hug of your legs. And now roll over onto one side, ready for side plank. On the elbows to start, stay on the elbows if the wrist hurts. From here, inhale. You can keep 1 foot bent, 1 foot straight, or both legs straight. Just up to you. Starting with the modification, you're up for 2, sit all the way down for 2. You're up for 2. Those of you who are ready for side plank, just go straight into your straight legs. Up for 2, down for 2. Up for 2 and down for 2. 2 more up for 2 and down. Last 1, all the way up, hold it here. Take a moment, halfway down, all the way up. And down, all the way up. Halfway down, lift, halfway down. And lift, 4 more down, up, 3 more down, up, last 2, and now stay up, arms over the head, let's go up, up, hold, up, up, hold, and up, up, hold, and up, up, hold, 4 more up, up, 3 more up, up, last 2 up, last 1, hold nice and still. If you want, you can float the top leg up off the floor or just pick them off up. Just float it up slightly for 4 more. Three more. Two and one. Float it down and one hand on the floor, the other hand on the floor, you're back to high plank. Take a moment and now take a little run. So mountain climber, in and in. Go right, left, right. Two more eights to go, guys. Here we go. Last eight, coming up. Four, three, and two. Find a plank, up to downward dog. Inhale back to plank. Up to downward dog. Inhale back to plank. Last one up. Now back to plank. This time lower all the way down. Release your legs. Get them slightly apart. Have a quick wiggle to make sure there's no sticky bits in your back. One hand on top of the other, forehead is down. Now, focusing on relaxing your butt cheeks. So really unclench, draw the belly button away from the floor, tuck the belly button in, and now slow the upper body up. Now lift up. Lift up and up. Go exhale. So you're not going very high because your focus here is to keep your bum relaxed. And then you lift. This way, because when we do back workout, we tend to go straight away to clenching the bum and floating up. We end up working always the same bit. So now keep the lower back, the glutes nice and relaxed, and just lift up. Just the eight more here, very small. It's almost like the warm up we did for our abs. And it's four, three. Now float it off the floor, arms over your head. And bend it back. If you're suffering from quite tight shoulders, take it out to the side, right? Let's go. Over the head and bend. Or if you're taking it out to the side, it's cactus and bend. And cactus, eight more. And extend and bend. Extend and bend. Breathe in, breathe out, and extend. Just getting used to it. Four, shoulders away from the ears. Three, ooh, last two. Ladies, hold it out there. Now, let's go lift, lift. Another version, you can hold the arms together and lift. Both clasp your hands together and lift. Or go back to cactus. That's probably the most accessible version, guys, yeah? Lift and lift. Here comes eight more. Four, eight, seven. Still relaxing your butt as much as you can. Four, three, and two. Oh, hands under the forehead. Wiggle out any sticky bits in your back from here, guys. Get the lower back ready. You float the legs up off the floor. Now, little pose up. Up right away into the glutes and the lower back. For those of you who are really struggling with this, one leg at a time, one leg at a time, just see where you are. Yeah, one leg at a time and one leg at a time. Let's go for it. Going up and squeeze, lift and lift. Well done, everybody. Here comes eight, seven, six, five, and four, three. And now, those of you who want to, arms up over the head and hold. Now take a little hold as you pedal, and pedal, and pedal, pedal. Four, eight. Four, three, and two. And from here, keep the legs going as you swim arms by the side. Lift up higher, hold. And from here, guys, just the arms. Arms over the head. And then when you close your arms, you close your legs. When you open the arms over the head, you separate the legs. And close arms, close the legs. And for those of you who are restricted by spacing, bring the elbows in and extend the arm by the side. Bring the elbows in and extend the arm over your head. So if you are, yeah, in a narrow room, here's four more in. And back out. Three more, squeeze. And back out. Last two, squeeze. And back out. Last one, squeeze, hold it here, and wiggle those legs out. Now keep the legs going, keep them together if you can. Legs as close to each other as possible. Now the arms go to swimming, freestyle, swim. And swim. Go swim. Try to look up at the hand. Here's eight, and seven. Yes, six, five, and four, three, two, one, guys, lower down. Now really breathe here. We're going to bum up. Remember, we have only done one side plank. So go back onto your back again into the... So take your time now. Feet, soles of the feet on the floor. Remember, we just did some back bend. We've just done some back bends. So from here, hug one knee to the chest, hug the other knee to the chest. Take your time, inhale here. Now using abs, using arms, gently roll yourself up into a ball. Take your time with your back. If this is too intense, just leave the head and shoulders down and hug the legs to your chest. Once you know, the back feels absolutely fine, you start to curl the head and shoulders off the floor. Eventually, we all meet in a little ball here. Now, one arm, same leg, extend away from each other and come back in. The other side, extend away from each other and come back in. Now, one arm and come back in. And the other, now let's go for both arms. Here we go, extend, exhale, inhale to hug, exhale. Or indeed, if you prefer to inhale to extend, just stay consistent on your breathing. And back in. Let's have four more like this. Out. And back in. And in. Three more. Out. And back in. Now, if you are restricted by spaces, just swipe the leg, the arms over you. Of course, if there's space around you, by all means, do nice big circles. Yeah. Last one. We all hold out in that dish. Arms by the ear, if this is too much, arms by the side of the sides. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hands go behind the head from here. Now bring the legs back to tabletop and then bending your legs. Flex the foot, turn out to first position. Let's go for it. So crunching up to close your legs. Inhale to lower down only halfway and to open the legs. So up to crunch, close and open. Here you go. Crunch to squeeze. And down, crunch, squeeze, and down, squeeze, crunch, and down, squeeze, crunch, and down, squeeze those inner thighs, squeeze, and down. Now, double time, it's crunch, and squeeze, and crunch, and squeeze, breathe out, and up, and out. Here's 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Now, stay up, but open the legs out to first position. Now, out, double double pace. And bend it back in. Out to double développé. If you're struggling, guys, get the legs a bit higher. Just keep them on that side of the hip, so yeah. If you're still struggling, head and shoulders down and do what you can, yeah. Four more out and back down. Three more out and back down. Last two and back in. Last one, hold it out there. Now from here, stabilize the pelvis, circle one leg. Now, if you find that your pelvis is going to flip you over, then make the circle smaller. Priority is to absolutely secure yourself on the floor. No flipping side to side. And keep the head and shoulders up if that's an option. Reverse the circle. For those of you who want to, you can take it super wide. As long as your pelvis doesn't go out of shape. Yeah. 4, 3, 2. Now, point the leg out to the side, either here or take it right out and crunch. 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 And crunch, go crunch, and squeeze, and crunch. Here comes 8 more. Here's 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Come back to first position, plie, and straighten, and you crunch as you go. Go down, and stretch, and down, and straighten. Crunch as you stretch, and crunch. 4 more here, and 4, 3, and crunch. Last 2, and now this time stay up, legs out. Circle the other leg. Same rules apply. Yeah. As long as you're absolutely stable on the floor, you can draw that leg as wide as you want. If you're flipping over in any way, please just make it smaller. Now reverse direction. It can be as small as this or as wide as is the width of your room. 4 more here. 4, 3, 2. Point the leg out to the side. Let's crunch up. Up. And now some of you might be like me a few inches. Some might be out 90 degrees. Let's go for it. And up. And up. Let's go. Last 8. Here comes 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Hug the knees in. Now give a quick rock and roll forward in the back. Your arm to the side, over to the other side plane. From here, of course, you can just simply flip around the other side. Starting on the knees or straight away on your feet from here. Like all the way up for 2 and down for 2. All the way up for 2 and down for 2. Exhale, inhale. Now those of you who are needing modification, that's just a little easier, but not much. Or indeed, bottom leg down or both legs down. Now, no shame in the choices you make. Just be happy and honest to yourself with the choice you make. Now, double time. So, halfway down, all the way up. Halfway down, all the way up. So the bum doesn't touch the floor. Halfway down, all the way up. And four, press. Three, and up. Last, two, and up. Now, stay right up, arms over the head. Now, up, up, hold. Up, up, hold. And up, up, hold. And up, up, hold. Four, up, up, hold. And three, up, hold. Last two. Now hold your eight counts. You can do any variations you like. Any variations you like. For four, and three, and two, and one. Hug down onto your both elbows. Take a moment from here. Rock forward and back. And forward and back. And four, and back. And three. Now extend the elbow plank. Last two, now keep the elbows right where they are. Walk the feet further and further until eventually your elbows over your forehead and you're almost kissing the floor. Now walk back in. Woo! Take a big breath in and breathe out in your more regular plank. Suddenly that feels easy, right? Let's go back out twice more. Extend it out. So that bring the bum down with you so you're not hovering up here. All the way out as long as you can. That's it. So walk out until the elbows end up around your forehead, if possible. Yeah. Nice. I know it's horrible. You feel like you can't breathe. Now walk the feet back in, elbows back under the shoulders. Yes, guys. Let's have one more. Take the breath in. And let's go again. Or walk the feet out, out, out until eventually elbows are by your forehead. Ah, four, three, two, and one. Walk it back in, guys. Ooh, from here, onto one hand. Have a look. Onto the other hand. Take a moment, you're up to downward dog and back to plank. And up to downward dog, a few cardio hit here, yeah? Coming up, 2 minutes of cardio, let's go guys. Back to that plank, you go right, left, right. I'm gonna set the clock, 2 minutes of different cardio here. Go and come in. Go right, left, right, and right, left, right. Now if it's getting boring, take the legs across opposite elbow, take a twist. Up, up. Those of you who want to do abs, really fine to do it slower, guys, yeah? If you're needing modification, watch what I'm doing. Just scoop the knees across. And squeeze, 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 squeeze. Roll it eight more. Four, eight, seven, six, five, and four, three, and two. Come to plank, right foot forward, and step it back. Left foot forward, and step it back. Let's go switch. Go forward, switch, switch. Switch now. For those of you who do not want to jump, just step. If you can't step all the way to the hand, just do what I'm doing. But the bum stay down. Well done, everybody. Any version. You can even use this opportunity for a little lounge stretch. Yes, definitely. Eight, seven, six, five, and four, three. Hold that plank. Final variation. Now step out and out. Tap the toes out and in. Or jump. And jump, and jump. Here is last 20 seconds to go. Yes, guys, woo! That whole 2 minutes of various cardio coming up. Last eight, seven, six, five. Well done, in four, three, and two, and collapse on your face. Ah, breathe. Breathe, well done, everybody. Now, since we're down, that's quite a lot on your shoulders, yeah? So open yourself out to a T shape. Nice. Now really lengthen the back of your neck. Let the heart slowly calm down. Take your time to catch your breath. Well done. When you're ready, roll onto one shoulder. And then just luxuriate. You can reach your arm up. Some of you double jointed can go back and hold the hand. Woo! Some of you can even release the top leg to look for the fingertips. Yeah, I'm having my tricky back today, so I'm gonna leave that out. It's just a little weird bit here, that's a little stiff. I'm just so happy I'm still, it's all fine. Just every now and then there are niggles. Now take a moment and give me an excuse to rest. When you're ready, guys, come to center. Have a moment in the center, no, not rushing into the other side. Acknowledge how it feels on the other two sides. Now go over to the other side now. You're in full control. those of you watching playback, what I'm doing is just illustration. You're in absolute full control. You don't have to take any of the options I give you. Indeed, you can even take them further. This is your workout, and this is just my ideas and of how we put exercises together. But you know, you gotta know right from the start what you want out of the class. Now come back to center and have another T-shaped holder. Now my favorite hip opening stretch. So my favorite quad stretch and also opening out the hip. Now pressing everything into the floor, two hip bones on left and right, and the pelvic bone right at the bottom there. Now glue your knees together, not a gap between the knees. You pick up one foot and then press everything back into the floor. Oh my, this side is tight. So you will notice little gap opening up between your pelvis and the floor. Once you catch hold of the foot, you press everything back down. If you still don't feel this in your quad and your hip flexor, then clench your butt cheek. By doing that, naturally you'll push forward and you'll feel the stretch. Now let that foot float away and another we go side to side. And now double check again. Have a moment acknowledging the difference in two sides. Now glue the knees back together, reach for the other foot. I always need to clench my butt cheek to push forward to make sure the gaps are closed up between my body and the mat. Let the foot float away and have a quick wiggle. Elbows under the shoulders, and then you can slide back either via puppy pose. So you keep your chest on the mat for as long as you can. Now this isn't, if it's not for you, just bring yourself onto your forearm, and with care, we all slide our way back slowly into child's pose, round the back over the other way. 5, 4, 3, and 2. Nice, roll your way up, guys. You're all done for core. Thank you so much.